Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Monday, March 28th, 2011. In the pre-market this morning at 9 o'clock on the East Coast, we've got stock index futures just slightly above fair value, but they're pretty close to unchanged, so not a lot of guidance from the futures in Chicago. We do have commodities down across the board in the pre-market on Monday, so we are looking for some selling in the commodity sectors at 9:30 Monday morning. Now, confidence is still low. The move that we're seeing looks like a reaction to the big sell-off that we saw, and I don't think that we're going to be able to go up and make new higher highs on this particular move. And so we're running into areas of resistance in different sectors, and at some point that will lead to the market pulling back. But right now we're on buy signals for most of the major indexes. So as we come into Monday, things are still bullish. I just am not expecting us to break out and make new highs anytime soon. Start off this morning, take a look at the 60-minute charts. We've got an early warning signal up there for the S&P 500. That would be confirmed on an hourly close below 1311.15 on Monday. Next target to the upside is 1328.13. We're stuck in the open gap over here to the left. If we move down and we start breaking down below 1300, then 1296.88 is our first target to the downside below 1300. Looking at the flypaper channel, that is right, the top of the flypaper channel is at 1300 right now, so that's where the band of support would start. And looking at the VIX is very oversold. We've got a nice big pressure zone. We're down at the bottom of the panic zones. An hourly close above 1799 would give us a buy signal. Now, we're sitting right on the edge of that right now, so let's give the VIX a little more breathing room. And we're looking for an hourly close above 1820 to confirm that we're going to see downward pressure on stocks. Moving over, looking at the daily charts, starting with the VIX. The VIX had a bullish reversal day on Friday, and that could mark the bottom of this move down for the VIX and a potential down move in the stock market. We need a close above 22.49 on Monday to give us a buy signal for the VIX. Certainly don't expect that we're going to see that. And an hour daily close below 11,912.30 on the Dow to give us a sell signal on Monday. Now, looking at market breadth for the Dow, we're right up at the top of the range for percentage of stocks trading above their 10-day moving average. We do still have 7 of the 30 Dow stocks are still on daily sell signals. So starting with Bank of America, and the banks have not really participated in this move to the upside. So we've got a divergence with bank stocks. We're looking at Cisco here. We're still on a sell signal for Cisco. A close above 1765 would give us a buy signal. 1988 for General Electric. For Intel, we've moved up. We've got stuck at the top of the open gap, and semiconductor stocks reversed on Friday, and they're stuck up at resistance. So that's something I'm watching closely besides the bank stocks. 2051, a close above 2051 on Monday would give us a buy signal for Intel. A close above 5919 would give us a buy signal for Johnson & Johnson. For Procter & Gamble, we're looking for a close above 6133. And for the Travelers Group, we're looking for a close above 5906. Looking at the S&P 500, no change there. We need a close below 1285.34 on Monday to give us a sell signal. Don't expect to see that. And we don't expect to see sell signals in any of the major indexes on Monday. A close below 799.18 for the Russell 2000. 2630.95 for the ZAX Microcap Index. We're looking for a close above 150.31. We saw Bank of America earlier. For Citibank, we're looking for a close above 451 on Monday to give us a buy signal. Looking at energy stocks, they're still on a buy signal. No change there. Gold stocks quickly reversed. They moved up above the previous highs, could not hold that level, and started to break down. And so it looks like we've put in a top here for the gold sector, and we're looking for confirmation with lower prices. For the silver stocks, very similar. Looks like we put in a double top for silver stocks as well. Looking at uranium stocks, still having trouble at the top of the open gap. Looking at the SOX index, a little bit of a concern here. We ran into resistance at 437.50, right in the middle of the range from the top to the bottom there. And we had a bearish reversal day on Friday, so that's not good for the chip sector. If we see fall through to the downside on Monday, that'll confirm the top for the chip sector. Moving away from the major indexes, looking at the 30-year bond, we're now on a sell signal. We need a close above 122.80. To give us a buy signal on Monday for the 30-year bond. For the U.S. dollar index, we're looking for a close above 76.57. We ran up to the upper channel line on Friday. And for the euro, we're looking for a close below 139.80. Moving over, looking at our commodity ETFs, no major changes here. We're still on a buy signal for copper, but not getting anywhere. We're down in the pre-market on Monday. Looking at gold, we're down in the pre-market on Monday. We need a close below 138.06 on the GLD to give us a sell signal, 34.60 on the SLV. Looking at gasoline, we need a close below 48. For natural gas, we're looking for a close below 10.85. And for crude oil, we're looking for a close below 40.88 on Monday for the USO to give us a daily sell signal. Okay, that's all for Monday morning, folks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again on Tuesday morning. We'll be right back.